Hi, let's talk about the associated structures of the oral cavity. So in the photograph to your right, you're looking at an individual with their mouth open. So the oral fissure is very wide. We can see some maxillary teeth there, some mandibular teeth there. Keeping in mind that the oral vestibule is on the superficial side of the dental arcade, and the oral cavity proper is deep to the dental arcade. And so right now I'd like us to turn our attention to the floor of the mouth. It's this horseshoe shaped region here, and in this particular image, this individual has been asked to raise their tongue to touch the roof of their mouth. And as a result, we're looking at the ventral side of the tongue and floor of the mouth. The most conspicuous feature here that we can see is the lingual frenulum. Sometimes you'll hear this called the lingual frenum. Frenum is the exact same thing. This is a bridle, so frenulum means bridle, and what it does is it limits the full range of motion. So people will have between their lips and their gingiva labial frenula, so there might be one deep there and deep there, but there's also a lingual frenulum there. So that's running down pretty much along the midline, and in some individuals it may be very robust, in others not so much. If it limits the motion of the tongue, this individual would be tongue-tied, as so they might say. So that might prevent an individual from either sticking their tongue out fully or having a full range of motion of the tongue. Anyways, so the lingual frenulum is midline, and it's met laterally, so I'll just draw these in here, by two sublingual folds. The sublingual folds are the mucosae that are invested about the sublingual glands, and it's really difficult to see photographically, but there are openings all along these sublingual folds for the sublingual glands. And so where the sublingual folds meet the lingual frenulum is a region known as the sublingual caruncle. So let's erase some of this so that we can see this undisturbed. Within the sublingual caruncle, we can see two openings, one there and one there. Those openings are the openings for the submandibular ducts. So recall that the submandibular duct is traversing the sublingual space, and it's going anteriorly, and then they empty through the openings to the submandibular ducts at the caruncle. So even though the sublingual glands are much more anteriorly situated than the submandibular glands, the submandibular glands have their openings far more anterior than the sublingual glands. And so sometimes pressure can be exerted upon those ducts, and saliva from the submandibular glands can be shot out of the oral cavity. Some people would call this gleeking. It's disgusting, whatever you call it, and a little bit amazing. But you're able to forcefully extrude saliva from that. These aren't particularly evident, but kind of running not quite parallel to, but alongside the lingual frenulum are the fimbriated folds. Do you see one there? And then there's one there. So just to kind of orient ourselves. So these are the fimbriated folds. They're going to be lateral to the frenulum. And they're going to be above the sublingual folds. And nestled in this space between the fimbriated folds and the sublingual folds and the frenulum, we can see the lingual veins. And in some individuals, these will be more obvious than in other individuals. Now let's take a completely different view. So this is a view through the pharynx. So the posterior wall of the pharynx has been incised and has been reflected away. And we're looking predominantly at the oropharynx. And so let me kind of outline that for you. So there's the border between, or the boundary between, the nasopharynx and the oropharynx, because we have the soft palate there. Here's our uvula, right? Down and around. And so it'd be the boundary between the oropharynx and the laryngopharynx there. So here be nasopharynx. So everything within the circle is oropharynx. We can't really see the a good view of the palatine tonsils and the tonsillar fossae lateral, but we do have a really nice view of the root of the tongue, or the pharyngeal part of the tongue, and all of this are the lingual tonsil, all of this rugose surface there. Again, here is our epiglottis. And between the root of the tongue and the epiglottis are the epiglottic folliculi. So there's one there, and then there's one there. And so these traps for saliva are formed between two sets of folds. So laterally, these are the lateral glossoepiglottic folds, glossotongue, epiglottic epiglottis. And then there is a median glossoepiglottic fold, and then the depressions between the two are the epiglottic folliculi. And here we can see a little bit of hypertrophied lingual tonsil going into that left epiglottic vollicula. So we've talked a little bit about the various accessory structures to the oral cavity, structures found at the floor of the oral cavity proper, especially on the ventral surface of the tongue, as well as structures in the oropharynx. I thank you for your time.